the Freedom Dividend is universal basic income by a different name, just test better. So we're going with the Freedom Dividend. Where every American adult between 18 to 64 gets $1,000 a month. Free and clear, you get it, I get it. It doesn't matter if you're working, how much you make, we don't care. You're a citizen, you're an adult, $1,000 a month. Now, the cost of that is about $2 trillion per year. Now, for reference, our economy is now $19 trillion, and it's grown $4 trillion in the last 10 years alone. We are the richest, most advanced society in the history of the world, and we can easily afford $1,000 a month. So the federal budget right now is $4 trillion, so $2 trillion seems like a very big add. But the great thing about it, this is not a government program, it's just circulating money back to citizens so that we can buy things for our children, repair our cars, go to school, start a business, whatever we want to do. So this $2 trillion, the way it's broken up is that we currently spend between $500 and $600 billion on welfare, income support, disability, et cetera.
Current welfare programs are about $500 to $600 billion.
Yes.
Okay.
So if you're going to give everyone $1,000 a month, but they're already getting, let's say, $1,000 in current benefits, mm-hmm. then you say, okay, you're already getting it, you're set.
Okay.
And so this $500 to $600 billion decreases the cost of the Freedom Dividend by about 25%.
Okay, down to $1.5 trillion.
Yes.
Okay.
Now, the big change you have to make is that right now our income tax system is going to be really terrible at generating revenue from AI software machines because they're going to do more and more work, but the beneficiaries tend to be really big tech companies that don't pay a really high tax rate at all.
You wrote in your book that Apple, Microsoft, and Google have tens of billions to hundreds of billions of dollars that they run through offshore.
Yeah, they do. So Ireland's a particular favorite. And so they just have all this money parked offshore because they can easily just assign revenue to various places. And so even as the big winners in this AI revolution make more money, it's very unlikely that the US government or society is going to see a lot of that. So what we have to do is we have to adopt a value-added tax, which is something that every other industrialized country in the world has except for us. So it's us modernizing and getting with the program. And because our economy is so large, a value-added tax at half the average European level would generate about $800 billion in revenue.
So Europe's about 20% value-added tax.
Yeah. And so
what does that look like then for like a company like Apple then?
So what would happen is that Apple would be paying a value-added tax at every step of the production process, and then their cost go up by about that amount, total amount.
So about 20% more for a MacBook or an iPhone.
Well, it'd be about 10%, though traditionally companies end up eating some part of that and then passing some of it along to consumers. So it could be that that the price of like the iPad or whatever goes up like 8% or something along those lines. But keep in mind though, you've got $1,000 extra a month and so has everyone else. And so everyone, like the bottom 94% of the U.S. population will end up with an increase in purchasing power.
But then the question then is, if the items are costing more money, if there is that slight inflation of the cost of the items, then how much is that offset this $1,000 a month that I'm making? Yeah, it'll give me the ability to maybe buy it, but then these normal items like food and water and electricity are. How much have they went up, and how much does that take away from my $1,000 that I'm earning?
Well, it just depends upon how much you consume, and that's one of the beauties of this system, is that the average American is consuming nowhere close to the threshold where they would lose. Again, the bottom 94% of Americans would see an increase in purchasing power. You need to consume an awful lot in order to have the VAT be more than $1,000 a month. And if you're at that apex of society, then that's great. It's great for you. Even the wealthy people I know, and I do know some wealthy people, they prefer a consumption tax regime to something like a wealth tax or even higher income taxes because what they'll say is, look, I can control my consumption. I can get a slightly smaller yacht or jet or whatever, but I can't control my wealth. And so if you tax my wealth, it's going to make me really mad. Mm-hmm. But if you tax my consumption, then I'll be like, yeah, that's fine. And again, every other major industrialized country already has it. some at twice the level. So this is something that people are very, very accustomed to.
So value-added tax taxes consumption, which is why people are more okay with it.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so value-added tax at half the European level gets you $800 billion. So that plus the $500 billion gets you up to about $1.3 trillion.
Out of the two.
Yeah. Now, here's the beauty of it, is that if you give people $1,000 a month, they're going to spend it. Right now, 59% of Americans can't afford an unexpected $500 bill. Everyone's really cash-strapped and living paycheck to paycheck. So with an extra $1,000,
us included, support on Patreon.com. The link is below.
Yeah, sure.
Support Yang 2020.
Yeah, I mean, let's do it. It's going to help creatives, artists, entrepreneurs. The Freedom Dividend will be the greatest catalyst to entrepreneurship and creativity in the history of the world. So you put $1,000 a month into people's hands, they're going to spend it, they're going to create things, and it's going to create 4.5 million new jobs and grow the economy by 13% or $2.5 trillion, according to the Roosevelt Institute that modeled this out. So it's going to be this incredible boom, and the U.S. government gets back about $500 billion of that in new revenue, because if the economy booms by $2.5 trillion, of course, the government's going to get its fair share. So that gets you up to 90% of the cost of the Freedom Dividend. And then you get the last couple hundred billion from cost savings to healthcare, incarceration, homelessness services. It gets very expensive when people hit our institutions.
Yeah.
There's one study that showed that if you give a poor family $1, it'll save us $7. So keeping people functional with $1,000 a month actually is going to be this incredible value multiplier. Mental health will improve, graduation rates will rise, nutrition gets better, like all of these things that will be incredible value adds. And you know what goes down? Hospital visits, domestic violence, criminality, you know, like all of these things. So it pays for itself. And what I'm suggesting isn't even aggressive. Like you could say, hey, we're really going to like create this, which we will. But even if you're conservative, this thing's very affordable.